Lucia e
My name
Olivia
is Lucia and I'm leading your visit of Palazzo Rosso among the extraordinary frescoes on the second upper floor painted in the 80s of the 17th century by Gregorio de Ferrari, Domenico Piola and his son Paolo Gerolamo, with the collaboration of quadraturism and stucco artists. Palazzo Rosso stands in Via Garibaldi, the so-called Strada Nuova, designed in the mid-16th century to house the most important families of the Genoese aristocracy. Today the palace is called with a nickname that derives from the color of its facade, and it houses one of the headquarters of Strada Nuova museums, together with Palazzo Bianco and Palazzo Tursi. Its history is linked to the Brignole Sale family, who owned it for two centuries, until when, in 1874, the last heir, Maria Brignole Sale de Ferrari, Duchess of Galliera, donated it to Genoa together with her important art collections. Palazzo Rosso was built between 1671 and 1677, designed by the architect Pietro Antonio Corradi, as the residence of the brothers Ridolfo and Gianfrancesco Brignole Sale. The decorative program was developed from the central hall, continuing through the four rooms to the east until reaching the loggia facing south, in continuous relationship and dialogue between the side room and the central one, a place of magnification, of power and connection point of the iconographic layout. It was therefore a complex project for which artists with different background were commissioned with the walls decoration, which were architectures painted Trompe-l'œil. The artists have been working here between 1687 and 1689 under the guidance of two leading figures and protagonists of the second half of the Genoese 17th century, the painters Domenico Piola and Gregorio de Ferrari. Unfortunately, the bombardments on the Second World War destroyed the vault and the central hall with fresco that had been entrusted to Gregorio de Ferrari, thus deleting the fundamental part of the decorative project conceived as usually. The iconographic path started in the main hall and it was completed in the four marvelous rooms to the east, where the ambitious message of dynastic exaltation of the client is developed. Through the theme of season, in order of their succession throughout the year, all around the sun. The spring hall is the first one we meet. Its vault fresco with great compositional freedom by Gregorio de Ferrari depicts the love that wins over the war. It is represented by Venus in a mincing attitude who seduces and triumphs over Mars, while Cupid sets torches on fire and is supported by a swan, an allusion to the law of arts. The myth of love is here a metaphor for spring, whose advent is recalled by the cycle of the equinox visible in the sky. The vault has an extraordinary illusionistic effect, accentuated by the material of the stucco, that makes the painted space perceived as real and enhances the figures with its protrusions. The stucco decorations were created by Giacomo Maria Muttone under the skillful guidance of Gregorio de Ferrari, and they have the same marvelous result as the frescoes in a solution of continuity with the pictorial sign. In the second hall to the east, frescoed by Gregorio de Ferrari, in the large sky of the vault, figurative images, architectural perspective and stucco elements stand out. We are in the summer hall where Ceres, the goddess of the harvest, supports a large bundle of golden spikes. She is contrasted by the figures of the winter winds, chained by Aura, the nymph symbolizing the breeze. At the center of the vault, there is Apollo, totally immersed in the sunbeams, and in close correspondence with the god, there is a lion, in its symbolic function as both the heraldic emblem of the Brignole Sale family and the constellation of summer at its peak. In the two following rooms, it was Domenico Piola who intervened in the project and the fresco decorations. His privileged position with respect to the other artists involved emerges from the payments in his favor. This element suggests a possible role for Piola as supervisor and responsible for the entire building site. as well as the recognition of his undisputed professionalism as a painter and a great decorator. In the autumn, Piola designed both painted figures and illusive architectures, guiding the Bolognese quadraturism artist Sebastiano Monchi. In this ordered and symmetrical structure, Piola intervened more freely in the central panel, where the theme of autumn is approached with an image of triumph. The triumph of Bacchus resting in the center of the sky, sitting on the clouds. Bacchus shows his beloved Ariadne his joyful kingdom made of sensual pleasures animated by bacchae, satyrs, and animals, which is illustrated with more vivid chromatic register at the edges of the composition. Also, the room dedicated to winter is enriched by wall decoration, this time entrusted to Niccolò Codazzi. Here, the artist painted a very suggestive architectural perspective that enlarged the space of the room. Here, Domenico Piola was responsible for the composition of the fresco in the vault. He created an open, eventful structure that does not provide a single view from the center of the room. In the cloudy sky, he isolated a swirling personification of the cold winter winds, Euro, Bora, and Ostro, which unleash rain, snow, and humid air. The depiction of winter and Favonius, the wind that tempers the winter cold, are contrasted. The fresco decoration of the loggia was once again entrusted to the perspective painter Codazzi, who worked in a winter hall as well, together with Paolo Gerolamo Piola, a 23-year-old painter at the time, who, even though closely employed by his father and master Domenico, was beginning to assert his compositional style. Two artists entirely frescoed the walls and the vault of the space, which at the time had been transformed into a gallery, closing and lowering the arches of the loggia initially built. Here, the depiction of the love story of the goddess Diana for the shepherd Endymion, made immortal by Jupiter but condemned to an eternal sleep. According to the myth, the goddess would come down from the sky every night to visit her beloved. And this is how we see her, in flight and distinguished by a crescent moon on her forehead, in the image on the first pan of the vault. Endymion, on the other hand, is on the back wall, represented by his lips leaning on his stick. Further reference to Diana is again on a vault, where a fake bas-relief medallion illustrates the chariot of the moon, allusion to another chariot, that of the sun, to which the decoration of the central hall referred. The correspondence of the two myths, that of Diana moon on one side and that of Apollo's sun on the other, is confirmed by the spatial opposition of the two rooms in which their stories are represented, the loggia and the hall, on the two opposite sides of the building. The environment that encloses the myth of Diana and Endymion is a space of pure illusion. We are in a ruined palace in which the architectural elements are semi-destroyed and the plaster detaches from the wall, leaving the bricks inside. In the 1684, only few years before the decoration of this room, the French fleet had bombed Genoa hard and hit almost incessantly from 17 to 28th of May. Churches and palaces were destroyed and the city was reduced to rubble. The episode, still alive in the city's memory, may have inspired the image of these ruins that we still admire today in the loggia of Palazzo Rosso.